Hey there, I'm Colleen from Drift, and today we'll be talking through the Salesforce integration. Now for this video today, we'll mainly be doing an overview of the Salesforce integration, so keep in mind it is much more robust than what we'll be talking through today. To get to the Salesforce integration, we'll go to the settings section of your Drift account. From there, we'll go into app settings and go into apps. We'll scroll down through our integrations until we get to the Salesforce one towards the bottom. Once you get into the Salesforce integration, you'll be prompted to connect your account. We recommend connecting with the admin account just so we can make sure we get all the correct permissions to sync over Drift activity to your Salesforce. Now, the three main things the Salesforce integration will do for you is, first of all, create and update leads and contacts in your Salesforce account. We'll also be able to send chat activity from Drift to Salesforce, as well as meetings booked. Now, how does the Salesforce integration work? The trigger that causes information to sync from Drift to Salesforce is when a conversation is closed. So something really important to keep in mind there, that open conversations, the conversation and record will not be synced over to Salesforce. Once a conversation is closed within Drift, we'll then take the email and search your Salesforce to see if that email exists within your account. If it does, we'll simply add the conversation and any other activity to that existing record. If it does not, we'll look within your Salesforce to see if there's an account with a domain matching email. If yes, we'll then create a new contact on the account and attach the conversation. If not, we'll see if we can find an account through enrichment data. And if we still can't find the account with the matching data, we'll then create a new lead. So what does it actually look like in Salesforce? As you can see here, this is what the conversation activity will look like once it's synced over to Salesforce. So you'll be able to see the full chat transcript directly within the activity. Now we'll talk about attribute mapping within Salesforce. This is really important to make sure you're capturing all of the attributes and data that you would like to sync over to your Salesforce. So any conversation, we can pick up any data and sync it over to your Salesforce. And that can be as broad or really specific as you're looking to make it. And this will really help you maintain your existing workflows. And also we'll be able to create custom attributes. So if you have really custom fields within Salesforce, we'll be able to create custom attributes within Drift to make sure we're capturing the information that you need. So by default in this screenshot here, you can see the different attributes within Drift that will sync over to Salesforce. And you can see these examples here are pretty high level. So things like first name, last name, email, but you can get much more specific with it and kind of get as custom as you would like to with these attributes. And that is it for the Salesforce integration overview.